There are some, very, just verbally proficient children in the room and some children who she wasn't hearing at all. And we decided on a whim to ask the kids what they thought was going on. Why are we hearing some voices and not others? And they outlined it perfectly for us. They understood the difference in the personalities. They understood the more talkative ones readily said, I need to create space for others. We ended up with a list of strategies that we were going to work on for creating space for all voices that came directly from the students and was probably stronger than the list we would have developed. But they are so aware of all of that. It's incredible.
We make some charts too, like anchor charts to help support the discourse. And sometimes I've started it with teachers where we make them for the students. But occasionally as we're like learning maybe a new learning station or game, mm-hmm. or we're thinking about what it would look like and sound like and feel like to have those conversations with each other, we'll make sentence frames and sentence starters and post them to help support the discourse. It kind of stops some of that parallel play that can happen when students are engaging and solving problems together. So instead, some of those sentence frames and sentence starters to help them know when we're talking to each other, when we're doing this math activity, these are some things that we can use to start that conversation, especially because sometimes I feel like they were used to maybe some more quiet rooms in mathematics.
And used to telling answers. Yes. As opposed to constructing understanding together.
I just was thinking about what that looks like in comparison to maybe how many of us grew up in education or our own instructional experiences and how that might be different. Where in mathematics, it used to be a pretty isolated content area where everybody worked alone and you worked quietly. And sharing answers was seen as cheating, where now we're establishing the type of classroom where we want to amplify their voice in the classroom. And so we won't be able to meet their needs if we don't know what they know. And so watching a teacher solve problem after problem on a board, only to record what they're watching a teacher do, all of that mimicking, that's not student thinking. Only asking questions if they don't know what's happening, or only speaking and only raising your hand if you're absolutely certain you have the right answer. That doesn't help a teacher really know students, and it doesn't help us amplify those voices in the classroom. So even some ways that we can have student reflect at the end of a classroom can tell us a lot. Asking students not only about their learning, but maybe about their disposition towards the subject area and the content they're learning about. Every piece of information that I get about a student helps me be a better teacher. And sometimes that might be, where are they with their mathematics learning, the actual content that we're doing? And sometimes it's, how are they feeling about this? How are they feeling about the partnerships? How are they feeling about the speed that we're kind of tackling some of this content? Mm-hmm. Their disposition matters. And if we don't ask, we won't know.